You know what I noticed when I was using this camera before and I forgot to do it? The lens is filthy. So, pardon me for showing a dirty lens at this point, but I will be cleaning it the next time I turn the camera off. So, anyway, what do we got going over here? We have 12.2 volts, so that's all up and fine and running. I got to build another shelf over here because I need to keep a place. I need a little cabinet, actually. I need a place for my hot chocolate. I need a place for my cinnamon spice oatmeal, a place to put my sweeteners, my paper cups, so when I have company. Because believe it or not, when friends come over, we hang out in the garage. I make coffee, we pull up a couple stools, and we just sit around here. I got that up there. I got my popcorn. I got some cereal up there. I mean, like I say, usually when I come out in the garage, I'm usually here for the day. I really don't care to be running in and out of the house, especially if I've been doing a lot of work and I'm filthy. So I don't want to get too involved. But I got to put another shelf up over there. Excuse me, guys. So that I have a little bit more room. And then I'm going to take this apart today and get this mounted. This is going to get done. This is driving me nuts just sitting here like this. So I'm going to get this started. And I really have to make a decision if I'm going to order that radio or not. Like I say, I don't need it. I want it. If I order it now and put it up, I probably won't be using it for 2 or 3 months. But again, I hate to lose a $300 rebate. The other thing is, when I do use it, I'm not the kind of guy that gets on the radio and just spends my life on the radio. With guns, I've done a lot of shooting in my life, but I'm not the guy that just has to go to range and lives to shoot. Right? They're all hobbies, and if the hobbies start becoming a nuisance, well then it's not enjoyable anymore. So, but I want it to be there when I want to do it. You know, so if I want to talk to somebody overseas, because I've got friends in Europe and Japan and all over the world that I talk to occasionally. Now, I haven't talked to them in like 3 or 4 years. You know, I've sent them a letter or an email occasionally, but as far as actually talking to them, no. So I make it on the radio once a month for maybe an hour. You know, I mean, it's that type of a thing with me. So I really have to think if I want to spend that money now. I mean, I really should, but I know there'll be deals out again. You know, that's all there is to it. So, all right. So anyway, I want to get that off there. I want to get this out of the way. I want to get that back in the truck. I don't need all this stuff here. This radio can stay in here. I don't really need that here. That radio is going to stay here. That's done. So the only radio that I'm going to have in the truck, basically, is the CB for now, which I hardly ever turn on. I'll turn it on if there's a traffic jam just to see what they're saying about the traffic and how far it is. And then I turn it off, so I really don't talk on that either. Sometimes I'll turn it on just to see what they say about the weather. The truck drivers, believe it or not, are your best weather forecast and traffic control. All right, they let you know everything that's going on out there. You don't have to talk to them, just turn it on and listen. So that's basically what I use it for. And that's about it. So I mean, I don't really need all this. And in the van, I'm going to be putting another radio in there anyway, about the size of this little CB here. Not even this part, just that. It's going to be another 2-meter 440 one piece. So again, you know, I don't need all this here. So I'm going to start moving this around a little bit, taking some of this out of here, mounting it up, and start working on this corner as well. And that's it. And then still, you know, drive myself nuts with that other radio. And before I do that, I'll just say to myself, don't order it. Forget about it. So. Hey guys, take a walk. I gotta put some wood on the fire. Let's see what Let's see what we have under here to throw in. There's a couple of big pieces. See what we got going in there. Let me stoke that up a little bit. As you can see, we got a big fire going. That's good. Put that on the ground a little bit and then throw it in there. Hold on a minute. Here we go. Let me go get a few more pieces. Hold on. Yeah, it doesn't hurt to fill it up. I'm sorry, guys, I'm back. Keeping you nice and cozy. Yeah, let me throw a few more in there. There's a big one. There's another one. And that should do it. So much for that. Let me just back this down here so we don't have so much heat going out the top. Let me throw this back down. There we go. Okay. So, now actually that wood that I just put in there, let me see what time it is. It's 1:45. When I go in tonight about 4:30, that'll still be burning. Put the timer on. That'll still be burning, and it will probably burn until about 8 o'clock this evening. I'll set the timer for about 5 hours. Well, right now I got it set until about 4, but when I go back in, I'll set it for like another 3 or 4. So that it keeps circulating whatever it is that's there. And that's it. So anyway, let me make my oatmeal and start on with this. Alright, so there's the box. Partially disassembled. The 2 meter 440 Yaesu FT400 is there, and there's another part of it someplace around here. I don't know where I put it, but it's around here someplace. And then there's the Uniden. This is their marine radio, actually. This is a, this also hooks up to a GPS, so it hooks up to your MMS ID and all that kind of stuff. But anyway, that was, when I had my boat, I had the station, naturally, you know, where you piloted the boat from, with radio, high standard. I had Standard Horizon over there, GPSs, radars, so on and so forth. And I had a redundancy on the GPSs and such as well. And then over on the other side, where the wife would sit, I also had another small station over there with an ICOM VHF Marine and a GPS color chart plotter So she was able to kind of see where I was going, just in case I kind of drifted off or, decided not to pay attention. She was able to see it. So she was my lookout. And then we had the handhelds, naturally. And then in the galley, I had this radio. Because if we were down below and we were, tied up for the night and I wanted to listen to the radio, to see if somebody's calling me or if I wanted to call somebody else, I didn't want to have to go up on the bridge to do so. So at that point, I had this one down in the galley. And by that being there, hooked up to a GPS chart plotter as well, the wife, if she was down there cooking dinner while we were traveling, because sometimes I'd be traveling, like if we were going to New York to the Hudson River, or up the Hudson River, and it was getting close to dinner time, she'd go downstairs and start making dinner. And then we'd use the intercom to talk back and forth. So, and when dinner was done, I'd just, slow down, back down, pull off, a little bit, find a good spot to anchor, drop anchor, or pull into a marina, whichever comes first. Drop anchor, go downstairs, relax, have dinner, watch a little TV, whatever, get on the internet. And then at that point, decide if we wanted to go on further or just, stay there for the night. And that's how it worked. But this radio used to be down in the galley, or actually in the salon area. So, all right, anyway. Now what I'm going to do is take this out of here. This is the CB, because this is going to go back in the truck. Now in the truck, I have a round table coming off the dashboard where I usually keep the computer. What I'm going to do is I am going to take that down, take that off. I'm going to move this radio back up against this. And then I'm going to put a little top on this and just put the computer right here. This way I can eliminate that piece off the dashboard and we'll be all set. And this will be down between the seats more, so less noticeable to people walking by. So, but that's where we're at so far. So I'm going to move that, and then I'm going to put that aside, and then I'm going to start going over there, and start to install or figure out where I want to install some of this stuff. And that's kind of like where we're at for now. Anyway, you don't realize how much time it takes to take things apart and put things back together. So, and we're cooking with gas over here while we're heating with wood. Yeah, that's working just fine. Have no problems with that. So, I think I'm going to make a little bit of oatmeal and maybe a cup of tea. Or something, and take a little break. All right, already I have a little need for this little Dremel thing without me pulling out a whole Dremel kit. This is that little grinder thing. Problem being is the radio, the holes in the radio where they screw into are a hair off. I'm talking just a hair. Because of the heads of these screws. So, we're talking so little, but just enough to where I can't catch the screw. So all I gotta do is make this hole a little bit larger. And I'm talking just a little bit, and that'll do it. So instead of pulling out the Dremel and hooking everything up, I'm gonna use this little grinder I bought that has the extension on it. And we're just gonna open that hole up. I could have went and found the drill and started drilling through it and ended up with all little chips, But I'd rather just do it that way, and we're done. So now I can move the radio back and screw it in. And then that is done. I can put it away.